Welcome to the spoken tutorial on Kangaroo Mother Care. In this tutorial, we will learn what is Kangaroo Mother Care, the components, importance, and procedure of Kangaroo Mother Care. Let us first begin with the introduction of Kangaroo Mother Care. As the name suggests, it involves keeping the baby in skin-to-skin contact with the mother and is popularly known as KMC. Remember, KMC should be given as soon as the baby is born. It is especially recommended for low birth weight babies whose birth weight is less than 2.5 kilograms and who do not require continuous monitoring. However, it can be used for all normal, healthy, full-term babies too. KMC consists of two main components: continuous and prolonged skin-to-skin contact between the mother and her baby, and exclusive breastfeeding. Let's discuss these two components in detail. The first component is skin-to-skin contact. It improves the letdown reflex and ultimately increases the breast milk production. Letdown reflex has been explained in another tutorial of the same series. The second component is exclusive breastfeeding. Note that exclusive breastfeeding is recommended for the first 6 months. Next, let's discuss the importance of kangaroo care. Prolonged skin-to-skin contact during KMC helps maintain the baby's body temperature and the baby feels more secure. KMC also decreases the frequency of infection and the rate of apnea in babies. Apnea is defined as long pauses in breathing. Apart from these, KMC improves the frequency and duration of breastfeeding. It strengthens the emotional bonding between the mother and her baby. KMC also helps the baby to gain weight than any other conventional methods, such as keeping the baby in radiant warmer, which creates stress for the baby and the mother. It also improves the satisfaction and confidence in the mother, as she takes extra effort for her baby. Interestingly, apart from mothers, KMC can be provided by father or any other family member too. We will now discuss the points to be followed by KMC provider. The KMC provider should be healthy and free from illness. He or she should follow basic hygiene practices such as hand washing, daily bath, clipped fingernails, tied up hair, and clean clothes. He or she should not wear any jewelry, watches, and threads, as these may become the barriers to maintain the hygiene, and it can cause injury to the baby. Now, let us discuss the type of clothes the provider should wear during KMC. Clothes should be front open and lightweight, for example, sari blouse or front open gown. Note that the KMC provider should wear this front open gown or blouse around KMC wrap. Kangaroo bags or binders can be bought from the market as well. These are useful if KMC has to be done for an extended period. Alternately, the KMC provider can use soft, clean cotton fabric, whereas the baby during KMC should wear a cap and a nappy. If the baby passes stool or urine during KMC, then she should be cleaned and dried thoroughly. Next, we will move ahead to the procedure of kangaroo care in detail. Firstly, the mother should stand in an upright position. Then, either a health worker or any family member should do the following things stepwise. By supporting the baby's bottom and head, place the baby between the mother's bare breasts in an upright position. Then, turn the baby's head to one side. make sure the baby's head is slightly bending backward. This position will keep the baby's nose airways open and will allow the baby to make eye-to-eye contact with the mother. Then, bend the baby's hips slightly outward. Remember to keep baby's arms above the mother's breast, legs below the mother's breast, and baby's abdomen on chest of the mother. Before wrapping with the cloth, cover the baby with a blanket if environment is cold. It will keep the baby and the mother warm. Then, wrap a cloth around the baby and the mother's chest and abdomen. While wrapping, make sure the center of the cloth is on the baby and both ends of the cloth should pass through the armpits of the mother and should cross at the back. After that, bring the edges of the cloth in the front. Secure these edges of the cloth with a safe knot under the baby's bottom. This is comfortable and helps support the baby. Also, it avoids slipping of the baby. Remember, as the mother becomes comfortable, she should learn to wrap the cloth by herself. The technique of self-wrapping during KMC will be explained in another tutorial of the same series. It will increase the mother's confidence and make her independent. If mother is uncomfortable while using a cloth, then she can use a stretchy band. It is easy and comfortable to use. While using a stretchy band, adjust the edge of the band above the baby's ear to support his head. Then, tilt the baby's head slightly to breathe freely and to make eye-to-eye contact with the mother, as explained earlier. The wrapped cloth or stretchy band should not be too tight or too loose. It should be comfortable enough for the baby to breathe freely. Remember, while carrying a baby in KMC position, mother should be able to walk, stand, sit, or involve in different activities. If a mother is very comfortable, then she can even sleep during kangaroo care in a reclined or a semi-reclined position. Now, let's discuss how to feed the baby during KMC. Either mother can feed the baby by simply loosening the wrapped cloth and positioning the baby for breastfeeding, or she can manually express breast milk and feed the baby using a cup or a spoon. Remember, each day baby should gain up to 25 to 30 grams of weight. Hence, expected weight gain of a baby in a month is up to 900 to 1000 grams. Hence, mother or health worker should monitor the weight of the baby during routine checkups. If the baby fails to gain sufficient weight, health worker should monitor the breastfeeding technique of the mother or check how many times the baby urinates. Also, guide the mother about the correct latching. Correct latching has been explained in another tutorial of the same series. Next, let's learn how to remove the baby from the wrapped cloth. Firstly, the mother should sit in the upright position. Then, start untying the knot with one hand and support the baby's bottom with other hand on the outside of wrapped cloth. After that, loosen the wrapped cloth with the same hand which was earlier used for untying the knot. Then, shift the hand under the cloth which was supporting the baby's bottom and use the other hand to support the baby's bottom from outside the cloth. Then, lift the baby up and free her from the wrapped cloth. After that, remember to hold the baby's head in a way where the thumb is behind one ear and other fingers are around the other ear. During KMC, the mother should immediately consult the doctor and the health worker if the baby is not alert and active, if the baby is breathing too fast or taking too long pauses, if the baby's lips or tongue turns blue, and if baby's feet are cold. This brings us to the end of this tutorial. Thanks for joining.